Picking up my sister from the airport, and the judges come to town. Here come the judge. Here come the judge.
There she is. Yeah.
Thank you.
She's in town. Doesn't she look good?
The helicopter mom has to keep close eyes on her son. They talk 10 times a day.
Call it what you want.
It's Carrollton, Texas.
Enormous cafe. Yep. This is some real Texas cooking here.
We're getting down and I say travels. Thank you for this opportunity to break bread together, continue to allow this food to serve and nourish our bodies. Yeah.
Carrie, tell them how you said that you could never find another man like me and you would never get married again. And something happened to me.
I don't recall saying it.
We had a conversation about not getting married again. Been there, done that.
Right. So you can't find another man.
That will not happen again.
But you can find another man. Okay.
Mom saw the word on that.
Doing a morning bike right here with my sis. Here in Plano, Texas. For those that don't know, this girl was a cycle instructor for 5 years. So that, what time was your class every morning? 5 a.m. in the morning. So it is 7 a.m. here in Texas, and on her body clock it's 8 a.m. So this is a late start. It's an afternoon ride. Susan had to be tough growing up. She was the youngest sibling, the only girl with 3 older brothers. I recall one time we told our neighbor who was 2 years older than her, my little sister can beat you up. So he came over to the house, and we called Susan down to the garage. We said, Susan, beat him up. The fight commenced, and pretty soon he was getting the best of her, and we eventually had to throw in the white towel and accept that she was our little sister, not our little brother. But experiences like that made her tough.
Okay, we're having breakfast here, and Tupelo honey and Frisco. This is the Frisco Star. We're gonna walk up to the actual place where they do it at the practice field.
All right, good. I was hoping
we could do it. Roger, store back.
For my sister Susan, I probably never would have played the piano. When she was 8 years old, she asked my parents for piano lessons. They bought a piano and she started taking lessons, and I would be on the piano more than she was. Often my mother would say, you have to get off the piano to let Susan practice. And then she finally said, if you want to play the piano so much, you're going to take piano lessons. But during that time, taking piano lessons was almost equivalent to taking ballerina lessons. It wasn't a macho thing to do. But eventually I gave in, and the rest is history.
Sunday morning, here to worship and praise the Lord today. For the new dress for the occasion. Ooh, man. You been working out?
It's good to be in the house of the Lord one more time, amen.
Oh, good. This is my sister, Robert.
Robert,
Susan,
like to meet
her friend Donna.
The train is leaving. Please hold on. The train is leaving. Thank you.
All right, Susan.
Thank you, darling.
Have a good one.
All right, love you.
Call us when you make it.